I'm standing in the middle of a field away from cell towers. There is a tower over there, but it's not very close. This field is also away from anything electric and magnetic, so it's a good place to test the lowest point of EMF devices. The sound comes from the Esmog Spion. It has what I call a true sound function. The sound function is enabled on this device. It is a true sound function, but in this area you can barely hear something on camera. The peak function of the orange device is enabled, so it is in its highest sensitivity and should only measure RF. The sound comes from the Esmog Spion. Now with the flat antenna connected to the Esmog Spion. The sound comes from the Esmog Spion. The EMF390 does not have a true sound function. The ticking sound comes from the Trifield. The sound comes from the Cornet. The Cornet has a true sound function. The sound comes from the Esmog Spion. The Esmog Spion has a true sound function for both RF and electric. The Trifield does not have a true sound function, not for anything. The sound comes from the Safe and Sound Classic 2. It has a true sound function, but it is hard to hear something in this situation. The sound comes from the Esmog Spion. The sound is a little different than before. This is probably because it is filmed on a different day here. Now Faraday box tests. Let's see how low the devices will go. The Esmog Spion makes static noise. The Trifield's peak doesn't go to zero. The Trifield's lowest point is the peak. It jumps around a bit. The EMF390's lowest point is 0.000 to 0.001 milliwatts per meter square. On another day, the Cornet's lowest point was a little higher. This device has a difficult to film screen outside. Its lowest point appears to be around 0.9 microwatts per centimeter square. Whatever it does, it looks awful. I cannot recommend this device. There is one flashing green LED on the Safe and Sound Classic 2, which means less than 1 microwatts per meter square. Now the second green LED burns, which indicates a level between 1 to 10 microwatts per meter square. When I move away, the LED drops. The Cornet is jumping between 3 to 5 volt per meter. That is not a good performance. The ME analyzer is jumping between 0 and 1 volt per meter. The performance of the EMF390 looks unstable. The sensitivity of the electric mode may have been forced over its capabilities to make it look better than it really is. The ME analyzer jumps between 1.2 and 1.3 volt per meter. This is unfortunate, but this can simply be solved with connecting the ground cable that comes with these devices. There are no visible issues with the EMFields PF5. The EMF390 does sometimes stay at 0.0 volt per meter, but other moments it doesn't. In weighted electric mode, the trifield goes to 0 volt per meter, the peak as well. In standard electric mode, the trifield also goes to 0. You can see that the issue is gone with connection to ground. The ME analyzer performs pretty good given its very high sensitivity. I think it picks up the camera here. The blue device is at 0 microtesla. This K2 will always show one green LED. In LF600 mode, the Cornet's lowest point isn't very low, but its more sensitive LF30 mode compensates for this. The EMF390 has a poor performance outside here. It isn't always like this. Often it goes lower, to like 0.3 milligauss, but here it doesn't. Not sure why, but it makes itself look bad. The Trifield's lowest point in standard mode is 0.1 mGauss, but the peak jumps between 0.2 and 0.3 mGauss. The weighted magnetic mode of the Trifield goes down to zero, the peak as well. The EMFields PF5 goes to zero. You just have to hold it still for a short moment before reading a value. I'm checking how it performs in three axes. This axis is okay. But this axis looks wonky. It doesn't settle on a fixed value. But most people will not hold it like this to measure, I think. And this axis looks okay as well. And for measuring low dirty magnetic fields, you must disable the sound function on this device, else you can't do very low measurements. The Erickhill goes to zero in both electric and magnetic mode. It has a difficult to film screen outside.